The hits just keep coming for the new operator of Manila's main gateway. This time, damage to a main water pipe caused a water service interruption at the NAIA Terminal 1. The San Miguel-led new NAIA Infra Corporation said teams are working to replace a damaged pipe as soon as possible, but it has deployed water tankers to ensure a steady supply to the terminal. Now, just this week, the 20-year-old baggage handling system at the Terminal 3 malfunctioned, causing delays in the luggage check-ins of passengers. Senator Grace Poe said affected passengers should be given refunds and compensation for the incident. An update now on severe tropical storm Christine. At least 20 people are reported dead due to the storm. The Philippine Social Welfare Department estimates some 2.1 million Filipinos nationwide were affected by the extreme weather disturbance. Camarines Sur is one of the hardest hit, as most of the province remains submerged in floodwaters. Dozens of areas are under a state of calamity due to the onslaught of Christine. Meanwhile, initial agriculture damage in the Bicol region is pegged to be around 10 million pesos. The Social Welfare Secretary assured the public the agency has enough stockpile of goods to aid those impacted by Christine.
Kausap ko kahapon si Mayor Legacion, the day before kausap ko si Congressman Elrey Villafuerte, kausap ko rin kahapon ng ating acting governor ng Albay, si Vice Governor Glenda, at ang assurance namin sa kanila, bagamat sila ang first line of defense, ang local government units, handang-handa ang pamalang nasyonal na i-augment o dagdagan ang kanilang mga supply.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. also assuring Filipinos the government is urgently working towards the immediate deployment of relief and recovery aid to the Bicol region. He adds they are intensifying preparations as the storm barrels towards other parts of Luzon. Here in Metro Manila, hundreds of families are evacuated as severe tropical storm Christine batters Luzon. Johnson Manabat reports.
Hundreds of families in Malabon City were temporarily evacuated due to flooding brought about by severe tropical storm Christine. According to the Malabon City Central Command and Communications Center, about 145 families or 588 individuals will continue to stay at different public schools since the storm still poses a threat to Metro Manila. The Longos Elementary School is accommodating most of the evacuees.
Bumaha po kasi yung bahay namin hanggang tuwid po. Sobrang hindi po alam anong gagawin.
Another evacuee, 76-year-old Evangelina, who lives under a bridge, was forced to seek shelter at the school due to threat of floods.
Lumigas po kami dahil maano yung tuwid sa bahay sa ilalim ng tulay. Yung mga apo ko po, yung mga ngalakal, yun ang kinakaya namin.
Malabon Mayor Jeannie Sandoval says the high tide made the situation worse, contributing to further flooding in six barangays including Ibaba, San Agustin, Katmon, Tanyong, Tonsuya, and Santulan.
Nakakabigla nga eh, kasi nung umaga, hapon, okay lang siya. Nung kinagabihan, ang lakas ng ulan, nasabayan pa ng high tide, dinomonitor pa rin namin kung pwede na silang bumalik na sa kanilang mga tahanan or inaantay pa namin yung bulletin ng pag-aasa.
MMDA Chairman Romando Artes is hoping floodwaters will subside quickly with the help of their pumping stations.
Yung pumping stations namin, syempre, pag malakas ang pag-ulan, yan ang mga bilis na magpapababa ng pagbaha. After an hour or two, after tumigil ang ulan, kagad naman pong humupa yung tubig baha.
In Marikina City, authorities have ordered preemptive evacuation of residents in low-lying areas amid the rising water level at the Marikina River. As of Thursday evening, the water level has reached 15 meters. Travel was also disrupted due to Christine. The Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange, or PITXS, 124 bus trips were canceled on Thursday. Most of the affected trips were bound for the Bicol region. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.